Okay, YouTubers, this is Joe from Artania TV. Another quick game of Interplanetary I Spy going on here. Back to the moon, back to Apollo 16 from the early 1970s. We have this image here, which is image 3029. Links will be below for all these images, as usual, so you can check them out yourself. Now, I thought I'd do a recap on this video because I did this about a year ago, just over a year ago, in April of 2015, and it shows a giant tower-like structure. Let's go to the tower, which is right here at the end of the video. As always with my videos, you can see all the main images right at the end and you can pause them and look at them and stuff. I'll let that play through a little bit. Now, this I spotted while looking. I went through loads and loads of the Apollo images. In fact, I went through thousands of images, and especially looking in some of these craters, because some of these craters contain very strange, very, very large objects or buildings. And this is one of them, and you can see it here. It's at a funny angle because the actual camera is tilted, because basically this was taken from the spacecraft as it was about 1,000 miles away from the moon at the time. And the area we're looking at is called Mare Crisium, Sea of Crisis here, okay? And the very spot we're looking at is just to the right of it. Now, this is the sort of view we normally see of the moon if you're in the Northern Hemisphere. And you, at the bottom here, this very bright spot here is Tycho Crater. That's the one where all the buildings are. So looking there on Google Earth or Google Moon, you will see buildings in there, okay? I promise you, especially on the west side of the crater and near the center, okay? So the area we're looking at today is here. Now, I've had some comments on this video fairly recently, and we mean to get around to this video, because people have confirmed that they can see this tower from Earth, this particular tower. And it is a tower. It's not an image artifact. This is actually in the image, and you can see it's actually joined to the ground here, this darker area of shadow. And there's to be some sort of buildings next to it or something. Now, what you have to bear in mind, I'll show you the actual image here. Now, I've got markers on here just to remind me where to look. This is that Sea of Crisis here, okay? And we're just to the right of it here. You have what looks like a rather strange hexagonal crater here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, is it 6? Yeah. Okay. And just to the right of that, we have the giant white moon tower. Okay. There it is. And it's in the image. Now, if this was an artifact, like something that fell onto the scanner or whatever, onto the... Basically, what these images are, that these are print, these are from the original prints. From the Hasselblad cameras, okay? So what they did, they took the prints, they printed them off, and they stashed them in the filing cabinets for many years, and then later on they decided to digitize them and put them up on the internet for everyone to look at. Of course, a lot of them went missing, a lot of them were damaged, some of them have been painted over where they've had things painted out, but this one hasn't, because it's an image of the entire moon, and it's kind of been left as it is. Now, we don't normally see the moon from this angle. We normally see it from further around here. So this is a different angle from what we're used to seeing. So this may not be easy to spot from Earth, but people seem to believe they have spotted it from Earth. And others like it, perhaps, okay? So there it is. That gives you the idea where to look. And I've already shown you on the map. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to show you the comments below here of people that said they've seen it. And there's one from... I apologise about the grammar here. Some of the grammar's a bit off here, but that's YouTube. That's what we get. Danny Griffith, right. The only reason I saw it in the first place was because it's shadow. And after seeing what you have shown, and if you type in the search Moon Tower, there is one video that shows exactly what I saw. Looks like the Space Needle. Great research you've done, and thanks. Awesome stuff. I would like more information, Danny, if you've got any more on that. I would like to see some more about the other towers that I may have seen the video already. I've seen quite a few in the past. There's also this comment from Excalibrate here. In no way am I saying that looking at the full or almost full moon with a telescope is not dangerous, because it is. But I am not one to follow the rules. So I was looking at the very bright moon with my Meade ETX 90 telescope in my backyard 10 or so years ago, way before I seen anything like your video, which is true. There weren't anything were no videos like that around 10 years ago. It was very interesting. Any surface features were washed out by the glare except for a large, narrow, pointed shadow. I think, wow, whatever is making that shadow must be miles high, and it looks sort of like a tower of some kind, but what could possibly be that tall? So I know that thing is 100% real because I saw it with my own eye. Awesome. So basically this guy has confirmed, I assume it's a guy, has confirmed that these towers, or at least he saw a shadow of a tower from the Earth. Okay? So this has been confirmed, or at least I also should mention, I have had some private emails from various people, some who claim to work for NASA or used to work for NASA, confirming that there are structures on the moon and there are towers on the moon. And these are normally the images that are obfuscated by NASA, and these details are normally removed from the image. They're either painted out or they're digitally removed or smudged over, okay? So this may be one of those towers that for years we've been seeing smudged out and removed from the image, okay? So there are bound to be other images of the moon with these in. It's just a matter of finding them. As with always, with many of these NASA images, they're kind of all archived and hidden away, but now most of them are on the internet and they are freely available. So it's just a matter of sifting through multiple images like I may have done, and just taking a closer look. And then you may need to really play with the contrast. The problem is with moon photographs, is they're very bright because it's quite a reflective object. And you really need to darken them up to see the detail, as I've done in this folder here. These are the original images from the video. And here we are. Let me show you the darker one here. Okay, that's been darkened up quite a lot, and you can see it very clearly. It's definitely in the image. It's not something sitting on the image where it was scanned in from the original. It's definitely there, okay? Now, some people have said it doesn't seem to have a shadow, but I think that's just the angle the sun we're looking at. That's it. The sun's coming down. I'm not really sure where the sun angle is. Let's see if we can work out the angle of the sun from the larger image. Okay, see, the sun is coming from this side, from the left, but almost face on, okay? So that's probably why we're not seeing a shadow, because the shadow would be just behind it here, this dark bit here, okay? So we're not seeing much of a shadow because of the angle. If the sun was further over, we'd be seeing a shadow this way or the other way, depending on the angle. So there we have it. I mean, you can see a darker area behind it. And let's look at the enhancements again. Okay, here's a close-up. It's very, very pasty, like a lot of these moon images are. You've really got to darken them up to see any detail like I've done here. And you can see a dark shadow behind. And you can see what looks like a base sort of structure to it as well. And there's a kind of little hexagonal structure here, which I didn't actually notice before, which is rather interesting. Okay, so there looks like there are some intelligent structures down here. I haven't really enhanced this much at all, and you can see them. I may do some more enhancements of this and really try and pull out some of this stuff, because there must be other structures near this thing. If this is a tower, which it certainly looks like, there must be other structures next to it. And there seems to be a top to it and something coming off it, almost like smoke coming off the top. I don't know if you can make that out. Let's have a look at the negative image. You can see it's just about make out something coming off the top here. Okay, so there we are. Giant white moon tower confirmed from Earth by independent researchers and astronomers. They are seeing these things from Earth, so the moon is there. It's not a hologram, it's not censored. You can see it for real with a telescope. Unfortunately, the photographs, many of them that we do get, are censored. And even when we go on things like on here, which is the Worldwide Telescope, here's the same area. This is the spot we want to look at here. It's by this sort of chaotic area here. This is actually around the wrong way. This thing keeps kind of spinning around for some reason. It's actually this side. But you won't see it on here because we're looking straight down on the surface. And of course, a needle-like structure like that would just appear as a white dot. And unless the shadow was pronounced from a different angle, you're not going to see it. So it's little point in using something like this to try and find anomalies, because unless they're large square or symmetrical shapes, you're not going to see them on the ground because the resolution isn't there. Okay, so there we go. I mean, you can check this out. I mean, this is a really cool thing to have, a worldwide telescope. It's free to download, and it's also, you can get Mars, you can get all sorts on here, Pluto, everything. But you're never going to see a huge amount of detail here. You're getting so far, and then it all goes blurred. Okay, so this just gives you a general overview. Okay, thanks for watching, everybody. All the links will be in the description as usual. Thanks for the comments confirming the giant white moon tower. If any of you out there also have telescopes, I know a lot of you do, and a lot of you are thinking of buying them, go for it and look at the moon. The moon is our nearest planetary body, and there are towers, there are buildings, there are structures intelligently made probably millions of years ago by some alien race, perhaps our great ancestors used to live on the moon. And if you look at the general weathering on the moon and how smooth some of the features are, especially in the Apollo images, a lot of these mountains should be big, jagged, spiky, mountainous areas, but they're not. They're all kind of smooth. Why is that? Perhaps the moon wasn't just a moon at all. It was actually a planetoid, and it actually had an atmosphere many, many millions or even billions of years ago, which could explain the weathering on the surface. So there's a lot yet to be discovered about the moon. We've only really scratched the surface, and we have been there, and we are going back. Okay, thanks for watching. I'll see you soon.